Hello guys and very welcome to my channel. My name is Angelica and today I'm going to do one look with one of the palettes from the Kaleidos Cosmetics Futurism collection. So this is how the box looks actually. I have another palette from Kaleidos. It's the Deep Sea Luster palette. I have a review and one palette two looks on this, so I will leave it up in the card for you to watch. And I was so impressed with this. This one looks like this, really beautiful. I was very impressed with the shimmers. They were like outstanding. I haven't seen shimmers like that. And the mattes, especially that orange matte, let me see, this one, it's absolutely amazing. I am so impressed with this. And yeah, so now I order the new collection, the Futurism collection, and it came in a box like this with this one wrapped around with a bow. And I wasn't surprised because when I ordered the Deep Sea Luster palette, it came in a box like this, but it was, I think it was purple and with a bow and everything. So the package they deliver is so pretty and very luxurious and yeah, very beautiful. And then you open it up and it looks like this, and you get a card in here and you get all these palettes in this boxes. I have taken this out, so I don't know if this is the right order, but so it comes in these boxes. This whole bundle retails for $59 US, and if you want to buy them like separate, it's $24 US. So here we have the palettes. They are very sleek. They are a little bit heavy, so they feel a little like luxurious, and they are very slim, and I really like the print of this. This is how they look, and you actually open, let me see here, you open it here with the magnetic here. So you open it like this, and then you have the palette there, and you have a mirror as well. And you actually have the name of the shadows in this slip, but this slip just falls out. So if you're not, if you didn't know before how they were, you don't know exactly, you can like do like this and then you probably don't have an idea. But I saw Paulina Beauty, I will link her video down below because she has done looks with this as well, but she glued this here on the back, and I thought that was genius, so I'm going to do the same thing. But anyways, let me talk about these palettes. So as I said, there is three palettes, and there is this future theme, and you have the sci-fi green, it's this one. I'm going to start to do a look with the green today, and then I'm going to do a look with each and one of those. And if we just take a look at this green, it looks like this. Such a beautiful colors, really like olivey green shades and mustardy colors. And then you have this number two, this is the cyber bronze. I'm really glad actually I bought all of them because I think they look amazing in real life. You have seen, you can see the swatches I've done. So this is more like a brown red and a silver actually kind of palette. I think that is actually gorgeous as well. And here you have the Astro Pink, and it looks like this. So you have really gorgeous colors. This one is like a purpley shimmer, really beautiful. And yeah, I'm really excited about this. I'm actually really, really excited because I was so impressed with that first palette. So I just knew I'm going to get this collection. And yeah, I am super excited to try this. And the swatches are amazing. I'm going to swatch, I'm going to do some swatches as well. Maybe we can just go into the swatches of this one, because I'm going to start with this one. So this is the sci-fi green, and yeah, let's see some swatches. Now you seen the swatches of this, and now I'm going to do a look, so I'm going to zoom you in. I'm going to start with this color, and this is the Radioactive. And I'm going to put this in the crease, and I'm taking a smaller brush for this because I want to like pack it on, especially here in the first part of my crease. Now I packed it like this, and now I'm taking a bigger fluffy brush, and also taking this Radioactive, but I'm just going to like blend it out a little bit. So this is a very mustardy color, but it goes well with these other colors, I think. Now I'm going to take this green right here, and this is the ET. And I'm going to put this here in my outer part of my crease, but I'm not going to put it, I'm going to stop right here. And this is like a moss green, I would say, like an army moss green. I just try to fade it out here when I'm dragging the shadow towards the middle. I'm just trying to do like this. This is really pigmented as well, I think. It looks like it, and it actually is a very beautiful color. And there is a little bit kick up in the pan, as you can see, but I don't mind that as usual. I don't care about that. So that's not an issue for me anyway. I don't have any fallout now anyway. But I'm going to take some setting powder because I'm going in with that black as well. So I'm going in with that later on, but I'm just going to take some powder, and I'm just going to place this like underneath here, like stamp it on. Now I'm going in with the shimmer, and on my inner part here, I want to take this one, and this is the Nuclear, this one. And then I want to go in with this one, that's Glamora. I don't know that word, if it's in the theme of this future space thing. I have no idea. I'm going to take this on my brush, and I'm going to spray it as well. Beautiful color. This is very intense and beautiful, but I mean, I have experienced their shimmers before, so, and I was super impressed, and I still am. And now I'm going in with that, as I said, Glamora, and I'm also going to spray that. Yeah, beautiful. So this is more a green one, like a green olive gold, maybe? Absolutely stunning. And I mean, look at this. You don't have to do like a cut crease with this because you can really get it like a nice line there, I think. So now it looks like this, and now I'm going in with that black because I want the black to, I'm gonna put it like here, and then I'm gonna put the green again. So, and I'm gonna put the black underneath as well. This looks really, really black. So I'm very excited about this. I'm going to take a pencil brush because I really have to be very specific here when I apply this. Yeah, Ooh. Ah, I already got black underneath. I really hope I can like fix that. But as you can see, this is black. Oh my God. This is really, really black. So I'm just placing it like this. I am a bit afraid of that fallout though. But I really think it's cool with this contrast, with this black. I'm going to take that green again, this ET green, and I'm just gonna place it here. It feels like when I place it here with that, like with that black, the black kind of disappears a little bit, but I don't mind that now actually, because they are blending together somehow here. So yeah. And now I'm actually going in with that shimmer again, that green shimmer. So now when I took the green here, they kind of like blended together a little bit here. So I have to put in some more of that black actually, because the black kind of disappeared a little bit. I just want that intensity of that black. Something like this. And now I'm going to do the lower lash line. I'm going to take this brush and I'm going to start like, I'm going to take a shimmer here in my very inner part, but I'm going to take this one first, this radioactive, and then I'm going to take this ET and then this black dark side. And I'm just going to start with that mustard color and I'm placing it here. I'm taking that green ET. Now I'm taking that black dark side. So I actually think this looks really cool. I'm going to take that shimmer. Let's see here. Yeah, I'm going to take that matte, like gold shimmer, this nuclear, and I'm going to spray it and I'm going to put it like in my very inner part of my lower lash line. Just like that. These shimmers are crazy. I mean, they are so bright. As I said with the Deep Luster palette, it feels like they look wet. They look like a mirror or something because they are so intense and beautiful. So I'm really impressed still with that formula. I'm going to try to wipe this off. Oh, yeah. Wipe this away. I will try. Yeah, I think the black disappeared actually. I'm pretty happy with this look, so I really love the black out here. I'm going to put some liner mascara. Oh, I want to put something in my waterline. I'm going to put this. This is the Vicon Cosmetics Long Lasting Eyeliner in Amber, and this is like a gold. This looks a little bit like this gold right here, but a little more like gold orange. And I'm gonna put this in my waterline, and I'm also gonna put some liner, mascara and lashes, and I'll be right back. Now I'm back guys, and this is the finished look. And the lipstick I use today is the H&M cream lipstick in Wellies and Tweed, and this is a nude, but it is more like a brownish nude, and I really wanted like a brown lipstick. I don't have like a very, very brown lipstick, and that would be really cool with this look, like a little more darker brown. So I just had this, but I think it looks good. And yeah, on my lashes, I used Allure Enchanted Divine Crime lashes. So now I'm gonna talk a little bit about this. As I said, the package is absolutely gorgeous, and the color story of this is really, really nice. What I would change in this one when I'm talking about them, these two are quite similar, I would say. I mean, this one is more olive green, and this goes to more like army, or a little more green in that one. So I would change, maybe I would take this one and put in more like a more green, like a darker forest green, like more clear color, like not that dirty, dusty green, more like a forest green that would pop a little bit, but will go well with these other colors. That's what I would do, but I really, really like this quality. I mean, the shimmers are absolutely amazing, and the mattes, I think this black, I don't know, it's very, very, very pigmented. I mean, oh my God, I was blown away. But when I took the green and put it like next to it, it kind of disappears a little bit, that black. So I put the black again. And you have to beware with the black. You have to have something under your eye. Otherwise, it will fall down and stick to your face, and probably will stick to your face because it's a really, really black color. But I think it's fun that they put in a black in this one, because I like this look I did today, and I couldn't do it if I didn't have a black. So overall, I really like this palette. I'm really glad I bought the whole bundle, because at first I thought I just wanted to get this one, but when I looked at the other, I mean, I'm blown away with these. They are so pretty. And yeah, this was it, guys. This is not a review, because I have to do a review when I've used it a little bit much more. I mean, and this is just my thoughts about this one. And yeah, I like it. I really, really do. I mean, the quality is really nice. As I said, I was blown away with the Deep Sea Luster palette. And I mean, the shimmers are the same in this one. I think the Deep Sea Luster palette had another formula as well. They have a satin, and they have like more glittery, chunky formula as well. But I mean, the shimmers are just outstanding. So I'm really, really happy. And let's see here. When you see this, it's Wednesday. So on Friday, you're going to see this one. I'm going to do a look with this. And this was, this was the Cyber Bronzed. Yeah, Cyber Bronzed. So if you want to see that, you have to watch my channel on Friday. I try to upload Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays. And yeah, this is it, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, you can give me a thumbs up. Then I know if you liked it. And if you want to subscribe to my channel, I will be very happy. And well, I see you on Friday then. Bye.